Oh yeah, right. He had no gun because I forgot to put sockets on him, so I've put the sockets on now. I'll show you that. Just been making some more alterations. So we've now got our character, our custom character and custom game class, so he's in third person. He and the bot character have now got sockets. This is an important step that I just have to quickly show you, that when you import your own character, if it's got no sockets, then it's not going to be able to hold a weapon. So we've covered changing its origin and getting the characters in with their materials already applied to them. This is another critical step to enable your character to hold a weapon. So, by default, what you do is, if you've used the UT male skeleton, then all you have to do to get sockets is expand the iron guard that's in the editor already, wherever he is. There he is. So here's iron guard, and just go socket manager, show sockets. There they all are. And then you would go copy with this pair of scissors here, and then open up your character and there, either or both of them, because they both need them, the bot and the custom character. So we'll open the custom character first and then go socket manager, and then you choose paste sockets. I've already done it, so he's got them there, and you can see the weapon holding sockets, the headshot gore sockets, so that blood comes out of his head if you manage to shoot him in the head. And then the same with the other one, the bot character. Because this is the most common mistake people make when they import their in fact, is he facing the right origin? Let's check his rotation origin down here. Minus 90, I think that's right. You can generally tell if they're facing the right origin by looking at the preview in the editor. So let's open that one first, because I know for a fact this one is. Now that's the origin he should be facing. So let's check the rotation on this one. Minus 90, yeah. So our one, when we first open it, needs to be facing the same direction. Our bot, I should say. And he is, yeah. Which is facing down X. Let's go open our map. And I've set a bot up in this map, but I forgot to mention that. I don't know if I mentioned it in the previous video. Quick bot here. I'll include this map package so you can look in there and see the bot. So he's over there, there he is, Mr. Muggins, our custom bot character. There we go, he's dead. And because he's not on a respawn, he won't respawn, but let's respawn him. So you can see how this works as well. So the next thing we want to do is go a new action. Actor attached. No, let me think about this. Let me think. It's been such a long time since I did this. Pawn and impossessed pawn. Event. Right, that's it. So, new event. Attached to event. A new action. Event. Attached to event. That's the one. And then a new event. Pawn. Death. Plug the event into the top of pawn death. Now the pawn being this one here, it's always a wise move to name your variables, not value, just the name, so that you know what they are by looking at them in the editor. So you plug in instigator into the bot, attach E into the bot, and then the death outlet here, we're going to right click that and go set active delay, and we're going to give it an active delay of, say, what, 4 seconds. So what happens is here, we spawn the bot from level loaded through this actor factory. When he gets killed, that triggers out the finished mode into attach to event, goes into the death event here, which then fires off this little link here back into spawn. So now we've got an endless cycle of bots dying here, of dying and respawning. Right, now in 5 seconds, Mr. Mug will respawn. We can just stand it because we know where he's going to spawn from. Ah. Simple as that. And because I'm crap at games, I'll let him kill me this time so you can see me dying. See, he's clever, he knows we're chasing him. Look at him, he's getting brave now. There we are, we're dead. Looking really odd, because we've just used the default physics asset, and generally you want to create your own one for some good physics death. And he will keep running around and just looking for some other mug to kill. Anyway, hope you enjoyed it. See you later.